So by now you've noticed that this is not a full 5-day-a-week updated series. That it's 3 days a week. It's mostly because it's kind of short. And here's Phantom. Completely skippable second encounter. That's probably better if you do skip that encounter. But we picked up the Pride of the Lion in the last episode, and that's what we need here. So put that in the lion's mouth, and now you have to destroy the lion with magical destruction. And if you are playing on easy, this particular fight does not happen, but since we are on above easy, we have to fight Shadow, which, before I recorded this episode, had no idea that this enemy existed. And as it turns out, there are two other enemies that I had not previously seen that do show up in here. So, you get a good taste of what Devil May Cry is like in easy, but they leave out three of, I guess, the best enemies of the areas. You'll see that for this enemy, which is called Shadow, I'm focusing on my guns. That's because anytime I tried to fight it off-screen, anytime I tried to melee it, it would kinda attack me at the same time. It would kind of retaliate, where it would not do that if I shot it. So that's the strategy that I use. And I'll use it once or twice more in the series as we run into more Shadow. That's how you take care of that. Pretty simple fight. I think on easy it's just a whole bunch of marionettes or something. Maybe a Sid and Sisters or two. But now we have to get a certain item, and the only way to get that is to activate this, and then we get on this lift. I suppose if I had enough points put into Alistair, I could do this then, but it's kind of impossible to have that much points for Alistair. Unless you're doing the Medium Plus, then you would have enough. You could just as easily get it the first time around with the elevator and get it the second time around the same way. So we picked up that sword just to put it in here. So this statue will drop the melancholy soul. And then there's a mirror. Showbiz up, tries to freeze on me. I have to investigate the room. No idea what that was about, but hopefully Showbiz doesn't try and freeze on me.
This stinking and was there's the last place I thought
some
I'd find anyone
dark nights. You can magically open doors. Wonder if he's a good guy or not. Well, the door is sealed behind us. I think we have to do something with this later. Might have been something else in that room, but I might have gotten another way back in. That door sealed. And there's the night guy again. What he's doing up there, I have no idea. But he's a boss. So pretty sure this boss's name is Nello Angelo. I'm not 100% sure if it's Nello D'Angelo or just Nello D'Angelo. Nello D'Angelo sounds like him. But he is another boss that we're going to be fighting. Well, as he is a boss, we will fight him 3 times in the entire game. But the usual way the bosses are handled is you fight them once, then in a later stage you'll fight just them another time, and then in a later stage you'll fight them again for the last time. But Nello D'Angelo kind of interrupts that, because after you take out Phantom, then there's another boss that comes pretty much right after him, and then once you defeat that boss, there's another boss that comes pretty much right after him, and I just died. But Nello D'Angelo kind of interjects all of them, plays out across all of them, actually. It could be possible that you fight him once in every boss, quote-unquote, phase. Once while you're fighting Phantom, once while you're fighting the second main boss, and then once the final time when you fight the third main boss. Now, at this point, I had played it on easy, didn't really have anything to worry about, because on easy you can take 3 vital stars with you, a whole bunch of orbs, a whole bunch of devil stars, you don't have anything really to worry about. Where on normal you can only carry 1 vital star at a time, which makes it difficult, and I just died again. So I have to use my red orbs wisely, because I get a limited amount, and I want to spend them in a way that will make me as strong as possible, while still allowing me to revive when things don't go my way. The main strategy that I end up figuring at some point is, picked up on this already, is that when he looks kind of staggered, you can go in for a hit. You hit him in the back leg easily. If he charges up for a blast, you can hit him. But the main point that you want to get down is while he's blocking, if you roll to the side of him or behind him, you can get in a few more hits. And pretty much extend a combo that way. That's kind of how you want to fight him. Evading pretty much all of his attacks, if not interrupting his attacks, and just doing as much damage as possible. Devil Trigger helps in that regard because it boosts your damage as well as heal you a little bit, so you might be able to take one more hit from Nello D'Angelo, but you gotta be lucky with it. As you can see, I'm not doing that well, but I am on the third phase of this fight. But it's not over until his bar is gone. Or my bar is gone, which it probably will be in another attack. And I just got killed. Just because you have your Devil Trigger does not mean you're invulnerable, as I just proved. He deals good damage, and the amount of healing I was going to get from that Devil Trigger would not be enough to sustain another hit. So here's round 4 with Nello. The 3 times that I fight him throughout the game, I want to see if the second round goes fast. This one is kind of in the middle, as I have already recorded the entire game. Because, why the hell? It's actually pretty easy to get through. It was fun. It was definitely fun. Albeit tricky in a few spots. Nemo being one of those spots. But the rest of it is pretty simple. Then again, it is on normal, which is the lowest difficulty you can be on while still being able to unlock it. But I think I mentioned in a previous episode that there is actually another weapon that will unlock. And I might as well just pull it out, there's another melee weapon. Because it's usually how the DMC games go, is you don't go just with Dante's gigantic ass sword and Ebony and Ivory. You usually unlock other weapons and guns, swords, is fine. Some of them you just have to pick up. Actually, now that I think about it, you don't have to pick up two. But as for the devil arms, as they're called, they're mandatory. At least in this game, they're mandatory. Guns, not so much. Make the game more convenient, but you don't have to get the guns. Some of them you can easily miss. And I just beat Nello, by the way. Is the a perfect example is the shotgun. I had no idea what the shotgun was. Did I need it to beat the game? I don't know. Would it have made it a little bit easier in spots? Well, yeah. But don't need it. Throws this over the rock because of our amulet. Interesting. Don't see why our amulet has anything to do with Nello. Okay, who am I to judge? So he flies off for whatever reason. And we clear the mission. That's fantastic. Took a bit too long and used up a good amount of orbs that I didn't want to use. Hence our devil rank of D. So that could have been better. That could have been better. But now we got mission 5, guiding of the soul. Basically, just take the guy, the melancholy soul, to where it needs to go before it kills you. Simple as that. So if there seems to be a audible jump in the commentary, that's because this was originally part of episode 4. Because I didn't realize how easy and fast this mission is. As you'll see in a couple seconds, maybe. But for the moment, let's buy some orbs. Expand our devil trigger a little bit, expand our health. Get another yellow orb, since we burned with 3 against Nello. Might as well replace one of them. Take a melancholy soul, which will drain your health, and another shadow fight. And you were given 3 minutes. Maybe. I'm thinking of a different one. There's a different mission where you have to transport an item to drain your health. This one you just have 3 minutes to deliver it, or otherwise I guess the soul goes bad. Shadow's a relatively simple fight. Even with how I'm fighting, it's just shooting him until his core comes up and then attacking his core. But Shadow has a certain tactic he'll employ once you get his health going. Which I don't recall if he shows that off here or not. whipping him. He hits me dead. What he does, as you see, is he'll explode. What he'll try to do is right before he explodes, he will try and grab you in his demon mouth. Grab, basically hold you there, and then explode while you're in his demon mouth, causing damage to you. If your health is low enough, that is an instant kill. That's kind of how you can tell if things are going to be an instant kill or not. Because usually the way they go is they might grab you, fling around a little bit, things like that. But if they just hold you there or something, then you know it just killed you. I think something like that comes up in a later episode. Because I just feel like spoiling everything. But hey. So, I'm hanging out here because the Melancholy Soul has to go into that blue door. So, I've got plenty of time. So, I might as well fight these Sin Scythes, if that's what their official name is, and get a few more orbs off of them. Because I have time. Had I the shotgun, then this would be done relatively easily. But, again, I didn't know where it was. Had I known, I would have gotten it. And that's that mission wrapped already. 3 minutes and 4 seconds. 133 orbs, and we got... what? B. Probably if we'd done that faster, we would have gotten an S. That's the only explanation I could think of for that anyway. Something like that, it's timed, so they're going to probably want you to go as fast as you can. So it's going to probably focus more on time than orbs. Also might focus on deaths and how much damage you take, because that does factor in. And they show you what factors in later games, it just might not show in this one. But, that is the first 5 missions down in only 3 episodes. Pretty good.